Hello. Tonight we're going to have a conversation with Julia Hanna and with Dr. Sue Savage-Rumbaugh. So we're having a bit of a lag. Oh, Sue.
Hi.
I see that you're here, but I don't see you on camera. I just see a picture.
It's got a camera with a line through it. I don't quite know why.
If you have an option to turn it on or to turn it off, you could turn on the camera.
I'm trying to turn it on, but it isn't coming on. It looks on. It's got the little green light like it's on.
Right.
I don't know what else to do.
Okay. Well, let's wait till Julia gets here because she's not here yet either. Seems like we always have some kind of problems. So let me introduce our subject for tonight, because we've discussed so many different subjects. And so I wanted to start out by talking about the article that I shared with you that I found in the Chronicle of Higher Education that was written by Geoffrey Pullum. It was after Koko's death. And the title of the article was Koko's Dead, but the Myth of Her Linguistic Skills Lives On. And I wanted your reaction to that article.
Well, I can say that I'm very glad that other publications such as Science and Today and others that responded that Koko didn't take that same attitude. And I'm not sure why the Chronicles of Higher Education did. I guess it was the person they selected to write. But I think that reflected the criticisms of Herb Terrace from the 80s and 90s. And I'm sure that Koko went beyond that. But one of the problems that we've had in the field is that those early critiques, which were designed simply to be critiques in the worst sense, they weren't really trying to help the field achieve better methodology or better understanding. The whole purpose of the critique was to remove the funding and kill the field.
Yeah.
And it seemed like there was a big acceptance, a rapid acceptance, particularly in the higher level journals, of that, as though the whole problem was not whether apes were or were not able to have language, or even more important than that, what were the factors that enabled them to have language, and how far could they go, and what factors enabled them to go further. There wasn't nearly as much interest in finding those things out as there was in stopping the attempts to find them out, which is basically anti-science.
Right. Yeah, I wish I could see you, because I'm loving this conversation, but I really wish you could have your camera on. Also, Julia is not able to come in yet.
It says I'm in a moderated video call that gives the moderator the ability to control the audio and video settings, such as turning my camera off or on. So I suspect that I don't have that ability, that the moderator has that ability.
Well, I don't. I have the ability to turn off your camera, but that's only if I'm angry with you, which I'm not. And so I have not done that.
Well, my camera comes up at the top of the screen in red, and it has a line through it, which means it's off. And it says turn camera on, and if I click on it, it turns black, but that line stays through it. So it says I'm turning my camera off and on, but apparently you don't see it that way.
No, I just see your profile picture. I think that's what it is that I'm seeing. And it looks like a picture of Kanzi and someone else with him. But Julia is also having some problems. She asked me to send her the link one more time, so I will send her the link. It might be possible that if I send you the link another time, that that you would be able to come in again and actually be seen by us.
Okay. Should I turn this off then, or?
I don't turn everything off, but if you have an option to exit for a moment and then come back in, okay, that would be good. I could send you another link too.
Okay. I think both of them are open. Yeah.
Okay.
I need to close.
I thought I saw you for a minute.
Can you see me now?
No, it's the same as before. I can hear you just fine, but I cannot see you. I see the picture. Now, for a minute, I thought I was seeing you, or it was just maybe a black screen, and I thought you were going to come on any minute. So let me see. And Julia said she was trying to call me on the hangout, but I didn't see any call there. See, I'm looking at what I can do, Sue, and all I can do is, you know, mute you or make you disappear or whatever, but that's not what I want to do. And there needs to be a camera on at your end as well.
Do you have a little control box, control room on your screen on the left?
I have controls over you, but what they would allow me to do would be to mute you or to turn off your camera, and I don't want to do those things. So I haven't.
Can you play with them and see what happens?
Okay. This is muting. It says you muted Sue, and so, and now I'm going to unmute you. Can you talk now? Are you there? Oh, good grief. See, I don't like doing that because then now it won't let me unmute you.
Am I unmuted now? I can't hear you.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, I must have muted myself as well. I'm sorry.
Can you see me now?
I can see a black screen. I saw a black screen for a moment. Can you do that again?
I was just trying to turn the camera off and on.
Okay. Well, for a minute, I saw a black screen, and then it went back to that picture.
It seems like my camera should be on, but...
Can you see a picture of yourself? I mean, can you see yourself on the screen?
No.
Okay, you need to see yourself just the same way that I see myself.
Yeah, I can't.
Julia could probably help us because she's the tech whiz, but right now she's having trouble getting in even though I sent her an invitation. So I will ask her this. I'm asking her, do you want me to restart everything? And we'll see what she answers.
Okay.
Because she says, I have clicked the link you sent, which takes me to my Hangouts, but I cannot join if I do not see our current conversation. So I said, do you want me to restart everything? But she just, okay, now she saw what I said. Yes, maybe we should start again. Okay, Sue, so I'm going to end this broadcast, okay. And I'm going to send both of you an invitation, and we'll start afresh, okay? All right, so I'll see you very soon.